Right, welcome to this terrain video, unique one. Here I'm going to talk about accessories, which I think are a majorly important part of setting up a decent terrain table. So I'm going to run through a few examples here in this video, and just to really emphasize how accessories, the small finishing touches, can make such a difference to your boards for your games of Warhammer 40,000. So I have a table set up here. It's like a very imperial industrial tainted chaos kind of theme running with this one. So we've got terrain. Battle map from Gamemat.eu. The terrain is from Games Workshops, so the Adeptus Mechanicus terrain. I've mixed it up with some Necron terrain, Dark Uprising, terrain with the Hive Walls and so on running around the board, so linking those up together quite well. And also the Industrial Terrain set from Gamemat.eu and the Warp Portal from them also. Now, one of the struggles with battle mats is the battle mats are great. They give you your colour palette straight away. They're very figure friendly. Nice and quiet for dice rolling. You can just roll them up when you finish. There's major advantages with battle mats for sure. But one of the downsides to them is the fact that they are 2D. They're completely flat. So there's no textured surface. As much as it looks textured, it's not. It is flat. And so what you find is when you put your battle mat out, you then have your 3D terrain, and there is that stark sort of difference between the two. So one of the accessories that I like to use is the stones and scatter, which can really make a difference on your boards. So if you look through here, I'm just trying to look for good examples of it. If we zoom in, so you can see there's Frank, the Imperial Fists Marine. But you can see the Games Workshop terrain just there. Then you have the battle mat with its rusty finish. It is 2D though, it's completely flat. But then in between the two, you can see the stones and scatter. And that really blends the 3D with the 2D. So it lifts the flatness of the battle mat and then just helps to blend in with the 3D terrain. I think it makes such a difference if you're able to do that. And so it's easily done. You can see these little clusters of stones scattered around the board. So I place them. I don't neatly run them all the way around. I put them in clusters. I don't scatter them across. I don't want the stones all over. I want them heaped and pushed into the corners to heap up against the terrain, but not to be scattered. I'll leave the battle mat with all of its design to run around here freely. But I want to heap up the stones just in little corners, little pockets, little patches across the board, just to break up the 3D terrain compared to the 2D nature of the battle mat. So with the stones, you can see some just in there. I want random and natural looking. So if you go to somewhere like an aquarium to get stones or the builder's merchants, usually the stones have been sifted and they're all sort of a uniform, generally uniform kind of size. So you can go for that if you want, but that is noticeable to the eye. You want something natural is preferable. So I've actually got my stones from the beach. I was on holiday on a particular beach and the stones are fantastic. So I picked up some of those. Now they're going to come to you in a certain colour. So then to get my stones, you can see the stones, the colour of them matches in very nicely with the terrain and with the battle mat. So that has been achieved by taking whatever colours you want, whatever sprays you want to use to match them with your terrain. So I used black spray, red spray, and also brown. I used trench brown as one of them. So the sprays that I've been using for terrain is from the Colour Forge. So these are big sprays. They're a lot bigger than the regular sprays that you get. These are 500 milliliter sprays as opposed to the 400, I think, for the regular ones from Games Workshop and others. So they're a good size can. These colour match in colour and in quality. They're comparable to Games Workshop sprays. I've been using them for models and for terrain, and they're fantastic. So a good brown colour is the Trench Brown from the Colour Forge. And then for a nice deep kind of red, then the Sanguine Red is excellent. And then just the standard matte black. Those three colours for this particular colour palette, which is the rusty dried blood kind of effect that you can see here. That's the colours that I used on these stones. Then put the stones in a tray, spread them out in the tray, spray them with one of the colours, let it dry, shake the tray up, spray with another colour, as much or as little as you want, shake it up, spray with another colour with the black, and then just keep going until the colours that you want become the dominating colours on those stones. So those sprays are available from the Outpost. They're exceptionally good value as well. You can pick them up for £10 each. At the moment, I think there's a deal on for £3 for £10. They're brilliant sprays. Really good size and great colours. And the quality, I've been using them on the models, on my models, and they're comparable to the Games Workshop sprays. The quality on those is excellent. So I'll leave a link below for the sprays from the Outpost. So whatever table I'm using, you'll often see the stones of whatever colour palette I need, depending on the board. So if it's desert, you'll see the same stones, but I've sprayed them up in different colours just to get them to match in with the desert terrain. But you can see them, I've used them just to blend in the terrain nicely with the mat. So a very key accessory, so easily done and can just make such a difference to your boards. Then to really add atmosphere to your table and add a nice theme and a bit of narrative as well, you can add in accessories like casualty markers. So I've got a set across here. It's some crisis battle suits and a crisis commander that have been destroyed. These were donated by one of the members on the channel, given to the channel, and then I've painted them up just as accessories for our battlefields. So there's a crisis battle suit. It always seems a tragedy to smash up models like this, but if they're getting good usage on the table, then they'll serve a good purpose. And then the channel member here has put battle damage on this for us already. It's good fun to do, to pose the models, to get them to sit flat on the board and so on. There's one, there's two, there's the commander brought down. It's tragic to see a fallen tower commander, but it does happen. So one of the games that we've played, we've done it, so these are all casualties in the centre of the board, and it's a tower game, and the tower been sent to investigate. They've heard that commander's been brought down, his bodyguard's been destroyed, they've been sent in to investigate, you know, who destroyed them and so on. Immediately you do that, when you place things like this on the board, you're generating narrative, and it can add so much interest to your tables. Again, comes highly recommended. These, what I would say is if you do paint casualties, then paint them up quickly and paint them for effect. So I painted these up, got them all done within the hour, sprayed them grey, picked out the colours that I wanted very basically, put some washes over them, such as Agarac Surf Shade, chipped them up a little bit of a sponge and some silver, and that's them done, nicely finished off. And able to go on the board. And it's a little bit of work, a little bit of paint work, and it just shows you put a bit of effort into them, but not too much. But I've got myself a nice destroyed tau unit here that we can use on our tables. And this would fit nicely on this board. Perhaps Chaos Space Marines in the area have destroyed some tau. And if it's a tau game, the tau are moving in to investigate what's happened. Or another faction could be moving in to collect some precious artifact that was with the tau commander. So all sorts of narrative you could do once you have these kind of things on the board. So that comes highly recommended. It's something you can build yourself. Perhaps you've got spare models, an army you're not collecting anymore, you've got some spare tanks, you can smash them up, paint them up, and then just incorporate them into your terrain for your board. So great fun, brilliant effect, and you can use them time and time again for your games of 40k. Or you can buy accessories such as these. This is a casualty set here. I'll put a link for these in the video description below. I would say it's about the best casualty set I've ever come across here. This isn't Games Workshop, but they've used these. These have been sculpted up to look like Death Corps Krieg, and they truly are a fantastic job. Again, it didn't take too long to paint, but look at the detail on those. And just to have these wandering around, scattered across your tables, so much atmosphere, so much narrative being added to your tables, and it's... If you can overcome the barriers of, well, do I really need to do this? I've got so much to paint. If you can just press on and do a project like this, you won't regret it. It's really worth doing. But these come, the sculpts on these are fantastic. Really, really good. Always love casualty markers. And there's loads of them again. Nice narrative, nice theme for your tables. So that's him. Again, sprayed these grey, a few colours, a few washes, chipped them up. Didn't take too long to do. So, again, really worth doing. But the narrative, the grimdark nature of this is really atmospheric stuff for your tables. So you can build your own, or you can get a hold of your own. These are, I think they're 3D printed, actually. And they come out as a set, so you get all of these in the set. And again, didn't take too long to paint, but I'll scatter these around this table. So Astra and Atara have been operating in the area, and they've taken heavy casualties. And then you can just scatter those all around the table. So finishing touches like that, I think, make all the difference for games. And so just sharing with you some examples of how this can be done. And you can build your terrain collection, not just with terrain, not just with battle mats, but also the important accessories that can really add the nice flavor and narrative to your games of Warhammer 40,000. So I'll leave a link for those in the video description below. You can get a hold of them. And then also the accessories like the stones have run through. That's not really a tutorial for that, just to explain how that works. It's very easily done. You'll also see things like these walkways. I'll leave a link for that in the video description below. There's a full tutorial how to make these walkways, the chain link fences, which you can see across the other side, and also the propaganda posters, which are brilliant accessories, again, just to add to that 40k theme to your boards. So that's the video. Keep a lookout for more tutorials on the channel. Thanks for watching. Tune in next time.